A series of earthquakes is ongoing just southwest of Guatemala's capital, and sadly, this has resulted in both fatalities and heavy damage to hundreds of structures. However, what made this sequence peculiar and why I received so many requests to analyze it by viewers is its exact location, centered right in the middle between three closely spaced volcanoes, one active and two dormant. So, is this damage actually caused by volcanic activity, and will it affect these volcanic complexes? Before I, as a geologist, answer this question, let's look at exactly what happened. At 3:11 p.m. local time on July 8, 2025, a light magnitude 4.8 earthquake struck, being felt by millions of people but not causing any severe damage. This was a strike-slip earthquake, but unbeknownst to anyone at the time, this peculiar event marked one of the select 5% of world earthquakes that seemingly closely preceded a larger earthquake, a foreshock in other words. As a result, only 30 minutes later, a moderate magnitude 5.7 earthquake struck 1,300 meters to the south-southeast, and this event sadly was deadly. As the ground began to rapidly shake back and forth for several seconds, rock slides were triggered, especially on some cliff faces, some buildings, particularly specific walls of brick, and certain concrete structures partially collapsed, and internet outages were triggered. This sadly resulted in 10 fatalities, more than a dozen injuries, and particularly heavy damage to many structures in the town of Santa Maria de Jesus, where a double-digit percentage of structures received quake damage. Then, across the next 40 hours, more than 200 additional earthquakes struck, more than a dozen of which were large enough to be felt via being in the magnitude 3 and 4 range. While it might initially appear that these quakes were occurring in a swarm, they actually represented a typical foreshock, mainshock, and then aftershock sequence with a decreasing rate of events over time after the mainshock. But why exactly did these earthquakes occur, and did their origin have anything to do with the three nearby volcanoes? For reference, the only active complex of the group is Pacaya, located about 9 kilometers to the southeast, which has not erupted since 2021, but has produced frequent historical Strombolian and Vulcanian eruptions, which produce basaltic andesite lava flows. 9 kilometers to the west-northwest of the mainshock quake, we have the Agua volcano, which has probably not erupted for at least 20,000 years and is thus dormant. Yet, this volcano is famous for destroying the first capital city the Spanish built in Guatemala via a landslide linked Lahar in 1541. And, directly to the northeast, 1.2 million people live within a caldera hidden in plain sight known as the Amatitlan Caldera. This caldera produced at least multiple sizable mid to high-end VEI-6 explosive eruptions between 100,000 and 200,000 years ago and last erupted 24,000 years ago. It is thankfully dormant, with no signs of recent activity, and its complex caldera measures 18 kilometers long and 16 kilometers wide. Taking all three volcanoes into account, it might incorrectly seem that the earthquake sequence is magmatic in origin. However, these quakes are all actually tectonic in origin, with events all clustering along a somewhat hidden northeast to southwest left lateral strike slip fault. If we zoom out, we can see that other potential but unconfirmed fault lines exist nearby, with a weaker earthquake swarm occurring to the northeast of the Amatitlan caldera in 1988 that followed the same trend. These events have not triggered any secondary earthquakes beneath any of these three volcanoes, implying that they did not cause a change which could eventually result in an eruption. However, all three volcanoes did experience an MMI of 5 or higher ground shaking, so while the theoretical potential does exist for this to have affected one or more of their magma chambers, it almost certainly didn't. The number of daily earthquakes in this sequence is likely to decrease day over day throughout the remainder of the week. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.